First contestant is Bree Vaughn. Bree will be playing the guitar for us today, so let's give Bree a round of applause and let's watch Bree play some fantastic guitar. Thank you so much. Next up, we have Justice Wisher and Jenna Guzman. They're going to be performing a duet of Karma Police by Radiohead. So let's give them a round of applause.
Thank you.
That was amazing. Thank you guys so much. I really love the effort you guys put into that. Next up, we have Bethany Walker. Bethany is performing a monologue about time. It's very serious. Let's see what she has to put on for us today.
The very first time I was ever looked at and held by my mom, looking at the world with my big open eyes and chubby cheeks, not knowing what the future holds for me, hiding under my cover, scared of the monsters under my bed and in my closet, running around with my siblings looking for the hidden eggs filled with candy, yanking and wiggling that one tooth back and forth just for a couple extra dollars, looking up at my dad while holding his hand and thinking, I will never love another man more than I love him. My mom putting me down for a nap, but all I wanted to do was play. Using chocolate cake mix to finger paint a masterpiece, believing that if my mom kissed my boo-boo, everything was automatically better. Leaving out the milk and cookies for Santa Claus, staying up late trying to see him, jumping and splashing in puddles as the rain hit my head and ran down my face, looking out the car window at night and thinking the moon was chasing me, sitting with all my imaginary friends and stuffed animals at my tea party, and wanting to be just a little older. Tick. That first day away from my mom, struggling not to cry in front of my friends. Being able to do my own homework by myself. 5 + 5 = 10. 5 × 5 = 25. Playing on the playground with all my friends during recess. Having my favorite book and reading it in my little nook in school. Getting a letter on my R card for talking in the halls. Raising my hand, wanting to be called on just so I can draw on the smart board. Figuring out how to actually write in cursive instead of drawing squiggles. Making boxes for Valentine's Day, because everyone got something that day. Learning how to tell time so I could figure out how to count down the seconds till school ended. And still, wanting to be just a little bit older. Tick. Trying to dress like all the other girls, scared of being different. Cutting open the frogs and searching for their hearts in science class. Coming to school with some of my mom's makeup on, trying to impress my first crush. Trying to run laps around the field in under 12 minutes. I did it in 7. The first time of many times I realized my parents aren't actually perfect. Finally able to be on a sports team, if I made it. Walking through the halls with my first boyfriend. Figuring out what type of person I was, or so I thought. Gaining lots of friends while also losing them. And still wanting to be just a little bit older. Tick. Telling my mom I got it all the time whenever she tried telling me something. My first kiss. Not really what everyone made it up to be. Learning that everything does not turn out the way I want it to. My mom realizing for the first time, I'm not really perfect. My first true heartbreak, crying in my mom's arms, her telling me I deserve better. Decisions that need to be made in a year that affect the rest of my life. And still, wanting to be just a little bit older. Tick. Every semester, the money I saved up starts turning into knowledge and debt. Calling my mom to ask her how I like my steak. And to put money in my account. Realizing maybe I don't got it all the time. Peers pressuring me into doing things I shouldn't. Life turning into a sleepless night of homework. And wanting to be just a little bit younger. Tick. Trying to find a cheap place to live anywhere without mold or cockroaches. Struggling to get any job that will take someone with no experience. Calling my mom and asking her for advice on how to do simply everything. Trying to figure out my life while I'm already living it, and still wanting to be just a little bit younger. Tick. Finding my forever best friend and saying I do. The first time I realized I can never love anyone more than my kids. The first day with an empty nest and a hole in my heart. And wanting them to be just a little bit younger. Tick. Calling my kids and asking how the grandbabies are and when they're going to visit. Trying to call my mom, but remembering she's talking to God right now. And wanting time to slow down. Tick. Saying goodbye and closing my eyes for the last time. Tick.
Amazing work, Bethany. Thank you so much for that. Next up, we have Lena Quasi. She's going to be singing Ocean Eyes by Billie Eilish. Let's give her a round of applause.
Watching you for some time, can't stop staring at those ocean eyes. Burning cities and napalm skies. 15 flares inside those ocean eyes. Those ocean eyes, no fair. You really know how to make me cry when you give me those ocean eyes. I'm scared. I've never fallen from quite this high, fallen into your ocean eyes. I've been walking through a world gone blind. Can't stop thinking of your diamond mind. Careful creatures made friends with time. You left her lonely with the diamond mind. And those ocean eyes, no fair. You really know how to make me cry when you give me those ocean eyes. I'm scared. I've never fallen from quite this high, fallen into your ocean eyes. Those ocean eyes. You really know how to make me cry when you give me those ocean eyes. I'm scared. I've never fallen from quite this high, fallen into your ocean eyes. Those ocean eyes.
Thank you so much, Lena. Next up, we have Joshua Knapp and Sarah Savage. They're going to be performing a cute duet from a Disney Channel original movie that features two great singers and a beautiful ukulele piece. Let's give them a round of applause.
Stop.
you, Josh and Sarah. That was absolutely beautiful. I really think that that should be on Disney Channel itself. I will email Disney right away. Next up, we have Eli Cannon. He's going to be performing a comedy routine for us. So get ready to laugh, basically.
We're doing the stand-up set during quarantine. This is awful, but let's do it. So, I'm going to tell you guys the amazing story of the Blumenthal Experience. Basically, the Blumenthal Experience is where three students get picked out of a high school in the greater Charlotte area to go on a tour of two theaters in Charlotte and get to see a Broadway show. And when we get there, there's a guy on stage and two girls, and they work at the Booth Theater, and they're going to give us the whole tour of the theater. So about 45 minutes in, he says, "All right, guys, who isn't afraid of heights?" And I am afraid of heights, but I lied and said I wasn't afraid of heights because I'm stupid. And he said, "All right, well, in that case, who wants to go up to the grid?" Now, the grid is the upper workings of the theater up in the air. And to everyone who raised his hand, he looks at us and goes, "All right." And he pointed to the corner, to a staircase that led up into the dark abyss. So we followed him, naturally. But before he went up there, he stopped a girl who was wearing heels and just went, "Honey, no." And she had to stand on the bottom. So we go up the stairs, and after about walking up 300 stairs, we get to the top, and we are now 70 to 80 feet off the floor looking down on the stage. And our tour guide, who, mind you, is about 5'4", is up there in the rafters, and there's cables, because there's a cable system that goes up in the grid, and he is just swinging between them like a monkey hyped up on Monster energy drink over these 2-foot gaps, which, like, with one fall, he's going 70 feet straight into the floor. Meanwhile, most of us are just sitting up against the back wall, the exact opposite of him, about 50 kids acting like they're on horse tranquilizer, just paralyzed in fear. And it was even more amazing, because as he's just, like, swinging around like a monkey, just jumping over these gaps like Mary Poppins, he is just having a casual conversation with us. And if he were to fall, we would just see him fall straight to his death. So the rest of the day was super great. We went on, we saw the show. The show was great. And by the time we had gotten out, I was riding with Fernando and Jacob, who are the other two people who got chosen for the experience. It was about 10 o'clock, 10:30 when the show ended. So now there are three teenagers who are sleep deprived because they've been up since 5:30 in the morning, walking out of a building into the middle of North Charlotte. As we're going down the road, you know, me and Jacob and Fernando are talking. We're like, "Oh, dude, the show was so great. It was a good time." And then out of nowhere, as we're just casually walking down the road in North Charlotte, 10:30 at night, from behind us, we just hear a man scream, and I quote, "Jesus saves!" And I'm not gonna lie, we all about dang near pissed ourselves. We turned around so fast, and there was no one behind us. So we just thought some ghost was just praising about Jesus, so we started walking a little faster. And then out of nowhere, from a distance, we hear, "Jesus saves!" And we were like, "Okay, Jesus does save." And we kept walking. And then for a third time, "Jesus saves!" And we turned around, and one of the homeless gentlemen is following us, walking behind us, with a sign made out of a cardboard tube and a piece of cardboard that has "Jesus" with a Z, "saves" written on it, as he's following us. So Fernando turns around and goes, "Jesus saves!" And I turned around and went, "Jesus saves!" And he turned around and said, "Hell yeah, Jesus saves!" And then we kept walking. So that was the Blumenthal Experience. Bye, guys.
Thank you so much, Eli. I'm going to call Comedy Central right now and get you a spot, because you really deserve to be on Comedy Central. Thank you so much. Next up, we have Adaliza Milan. She will be singing a beautiful piece by Adele for us. If you are a choir, get ready. Bring the tissues now. Let's give her a round of applause.
Scared of what's coming.
What if I